Tremendous gift. The cool thing about Holt Arena is that by replacing the turf, we become as contemporary as any facility in the United States and certainly in the Big Sky Conference. While a lot of other schools have had to go through arduous facility planning, raising, and efforts to build their facilities, we certainly have a state-of-the-art facility now that's contemporary, safe, and a great venue for not only games, but a great venue for practices. I know the coaching staffs in the past have had to limit the amount of time they spent on the turf due to the concrete underlayment and the lightness of the surface, because the surface itself had to be transportable so it could be multi-purpose, and that has always been the issue about whether you could build a multi-purpose facility. Could the turf be light enough, or could you overlay some surface over it to be able to hold your rodeos and monster truck shows? And simply for us, we had to have a facility that was adaptable to all the uses that we've developed over the 40 plus years that Holt Arena has been available. So with a great gift, we become contemporary, we become fast-paced, we become first class, and we become the leader of the pack in the Big Sky Conference about having a venue that can be among the best in the nation.
Coach, we talked before that this field was used as an anti-recruiting tool against Idaho State and how bad it was. I mean, is that something you sensed from around the league? And as you went out on these recruiting trips, was it the new field that you sold to kids saying, we're going to have this, they can't use this against us anymore?
No question. I'm one of the guys who used old AstroTurf against us at Idaho State as a former head coach at another school. And simply for us now, we're contemporary. We have among the safest playing surfaces in the world for the sport of American football. And as we saw in the Super Bowl, the surface itself can still be a dangerous place to play given the number of shoulder injuries that occurred in that game. But we're taking every precaution we can to make sure the underlayment of the surface here is as soft and as giving as it can be, given the concrete base that we have. And so all the schools in the nation that have a artificial surface are trying to find ways to make it safe enough to play on and certainly safe enough to practice on and still be multi-purpose, because the football team isn't the only team that's going to benefit from having this turf here. We'll have intramurals in here. We have a variety of high school teams that play in the area. So it becomes multi-purpose for the sport of football and multi-purpose as a surface used for other sporting events. So, yes, it was something we'd used against Idaho State when I was a former head coach. And it's something that we turn to our advantage with a great donation and a very forth. You really have to really credit the vision of Jeff Tingey and our athletic department and looking forward and trying to make this facility contemporary.
How did you use it when you recruit against it? What would you say?
Well, we'd call it concrete asphalt. And if I'd have been the head coach at Idaho State, I would have said, yeah, but it's our concrete asphalt. Fear the turf. And now we may have lost a little of our advantage, because we would have turned that into an advantage, saying, yeah, it's a terrible place to play. You don't ever want to play on that surface. So now it's a forgiving surface. It'll be more forgiving. It's certainly not natural surface. And we just can't have that in our type of facility. But the give and take of the entire event is the fact the roof doesn't leak, the walls still hold up, it never snows, it never rains, it never windy here. We play in one of the most perfect playing conditions in the United States, and our football team should reflect that.
And it will continue to enhance your ability to go fast, correct?
Yeah, we want to have the ability to get the turf down fast and get on there as soon as possible. But, yeah, certainly it blends in exactly with what we are. I mean, we wake up in the morning, and we have a great place to practice and a great place to play games every single day. And it will enhance our ability to use the natural conditions of what we're presented with to be one of the most revolutionary teams in the country.
Is this an important part when you talked about getting the job? Was this an important step that you thought in getting a program where
things to do? When I was asked in early November what I thought it would take to be successful here, this was my number one concern, my number two concern. My number one concern was the ability to have enough money to be able to recruit good players, whether they're from Pocatello or Post Falls. And certainly we have been able to show that we have that. And then the playing surface had to be more contemporary. And both President Vilas and Jeff were adamant that was well underway. And then with a tremendous gift from the ISU Credit Union, we're able to put ourselves on the map.
What form does it take to have enough money to recruit players?
What form?
Yeah.
No, you have to have enough money to be able to get them in on a plane all the way into Pocatello.
Jeff, a question for you. I don't know.
Sure.
How long overdue is this? When in a perfect world, when should have this been done? Was it years ago?
Well, it's so hard to say when it should have been done or how it should have been done. I think what we're looking at mostly right now is it's happening now, and we're moving forward with it. You know, we've got a great partnership, a great coach, and all the keys in place to move forward and be successful.
Jeff, obviously you have this great gift. Was there a lot of other donations toward this goal too?
We had to. Make sure I do all this correctly. We had a turf replacement fund, which was helping us in this, and then we received a. Another donation from our team doctors to help us in that.
Your team doctors?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, the Idaho Orthopedic and Sports Clinic.
And you anticipate it's down in July, ready to go?
Yeah, we've got that blocked open, in May. Both the university in May and June, the university and the high schools have their graduations, and so we need to wait until some of those are done, and also some of the early summer football camps. We'll use the old surface, so we'll block out that entire month for the new surface.
Is this going to be similar to some of the other surfaces in the conference, like at Eastern and Montana? And Montana State, I know, have all an artificial type.
Yeah, they all do. The first surface that we looked at with the idea of being able to remove it was the surface at Northern Arizona. They have an indoor arena that's used for many other purposes, and we spoke with the company that did theirs at first so that we could get an idea of where we needed to start from.
Has this been a fundraising effort that has gained steam lately, or is it going to be along the same way for a long time?
It's always been on our mind. We've known that we needed to get something done and make this improvement to the program and as a practice facility and competition facility for many of our teams. But it was something that we had to find a partner that had the same interest that we did, and ISU Credit Union had that same interest that we did.
When you brought in Coach Kramer, you talked about his ability to sell the public on this program and get the public behind him. Everywhere you go, people were talking about how exciting he is. I just talked to somebody today about how excited they were at the Rotary Club. That was shared by the president of ISU Credit Union. Have you seen him continue the snowball effect of getting people behind this program since you brought him?
It does. I don't think we could get him out enough at this point. We're going to keep going. Coach, you're going to be pretty tired at the end.
Yeah. I mean, was it a big factor? Did it help bring more money into this program, this turf? Was it already on course?
No, this was on course, ready to take place before we were ready to make the announcement with Coach Kramer.
Jeff, now that you have this very important thing done, what's next in terms of football that you'd like to accomplish to help Coach Kramer have a successful program?
For football just specifically?
Yeah, is there something next in the priority list?
You know what, one of the next things, there are a few different things. You know, Coach Kramer and I have spoken about upgrading our video editing system, upgrading our ability to travel to opposing teams by way of charter flights, upgrading our equipment. There are a few different things. If we had a list of importance, I couldn't say which one is more important. They're all very important, though.
Can you expand on some of the other programs ISU Credit Union is talking about?
I cannot.
Okay.
No, they will make that announcement in due time. I think one we can announce is, we're working towards ATM machines in Holt Arena for ISU Credit Union.
We are doing that.
Yeah. So for everyone that's a member of ISU Credit Union, that's no fees, right?
Yeah, exactly. It is no fees if you're a member of ISU Credit Union. What I can say that I did give a number earlier, there is a very large investment that's also going to student services as well. So as I had stated that we've been supporters of Idaho State University for quite some time. So the investment that we're making in ISU is not just in athletics, it's across the board throughout the entire ISU community.